Hello everyone, let's take a look at how you can use traffiq add-on in your own projects and save yourself a lot of time. First, we bring up the Angon browser and select a car that we like. I'm gonna go with this Porsche. When you import any asset, it is first a linked object. To make further adjustments to this car, we need to first convert it to an editable. Open up your side panel with the N key and navigate to the polygonic panel. With the car selected, click on the editable button in the Angon tab settings. Now you can adjust the rig however you want. You can turn the wheels separately, even animate their height, or adjust the tilt of the car for some drift turns. Okay, it's time to check the lights. First, let's change the scene render engine to cycles and preferably a GPU because it's faster. Select the object for the lights and check the rendered view. If you're loading kernels for the first time, it might take a minute, so just be patient. Now, with your light selected, navigate to the traffiq tab in the end panel, and under the light settings, you can choose from presets with different intensities. Here you can find settings for the emergency lights as well. At this point, you can animate your car manually however you want, but you won't always have to get the best results this way. An alternative method would be creating a curve object along which you can animate the car automatically. Just assign the curve path and the ground plane for the ground and then hit follow path. This works great for quick and easy animation you can later adjust any way you see fit. It interpolates the rotation of the wheels as well. To change the color of the car, I'm first gonna go to the rendered view. In the world settings, select the sky texture as the input, but decrease its strength just so that we can see. Select the car body and choose any color you like in the end panel's traffiq tab. I love this interior of the Porsche, it's just so great. Additionally, if you want, you can also add some more imperfections to your car, like dirt texture. This works on every asset and the same goes with scratches and bumps as well. Don't worry though, none of these features are permanent and you can always turn them off. For creating roads, you can select from multiple geometry node presets, and you can adjust the shape by going into the edit mode. You can access all parts of the GeoNode setup in the Modifiers tab, and turn some of them off if you want to. Or replace the trees by selecting another collection instead. Another way to make roads would be through the Road Builder. In this editor you can draw custom road shapes by just clicking wherever you want the road to go. If you create a new separate road, you can connect it to the first one. From that you can extrude it and create a crossroad. There might be some minor glitches in some sharp turns, but it still makes a good base mesh for your environment which you can later sculpt or edit yourself. When you want to animate a car alongside a road with multiple lanes, it might almost always be better to create a new curve object to use as the path. Whoops, this funny turn in the beginning was not intentional, but you can see our car following the road perfectly. Lastly, if you want to animate certain parts of the car like the doors, you can create a selection of this part that you want to animate and just assign it as a shape key and animate that instead. Now go and create some crazy stuff with all the cars.